The print module was designed with actually printing a photo in mind. However, you can create JPEG versions of these files, which is something that I prefer to do. I don't do my printing at home, so when I print, I tend to send it off to a lab. Or sometimes I just want to create a collage and share it online. So once you have your image all ready to go, go to the Print Job panel and select JPEG file from the Print To options. If you are planning on printing your JPEG file, then you'll want to make sure that the file resolution is set to the proper PPI setting that you need for your printer. 240 or 300 are two very common ones. You'll want to check with your labs to see what settings they recommend. If you are just printing a JPEG file to share online, you'll just likely end up with a larger image. That's not necessarily a bad thing, and you may need to play with this setting to prevent getting images that are way too big. I'll leave it as is for now and show you what the results are when I'm finished. The print sharpening setting is up to you, and if you know the media type, if you're going to be printing it on matte or glossy, if you are going to be printing it, then you can select that from that list as well. I like to keep my JPEG quality at 100 when I'm creating final images. If this is just a draft image or you just want a really small file size, then you can move that slider to the left. There's also a custom file dimensions box. My image right now is 36 by 24 inches, but this is one of those settings that I kind of want to leave as is. If I change the file dimensions, it doesn't scale down the entire image. All of the cells that I have inside of here are going to remain the exact same size that they are right now. So I'll end up with an image size that maybe I want, but the cells and the images are going to be bunched up and overlapping. So I'd leave this one unchecked. For color management, if you are printing it as a JPEG to share online, sRGB is going to be a good option. Other than that, you will want to check with your lab to see which profile that they recommend. And if everything else looks good, you can go ahead and click Print to File, give your print a name, and click Save. Now, if I go into that folder, I can see my photo is now a JPEG. And if I go into the info, it printed quite large. This image is 10,000 pixels wide, which is way bigger than I would need to share online. If I needed to, I could resize this in another application, or I could go back into that print module and reduce the file resolution, which should create a smaller file size.